deck.
You wanted to speak to me?
The name's Zoka. Have you heard from up north? From Bleeding Mark?
I'm guessing that's a place.
One of the desert's villages. They send their yield of ash blood so the Bereka over there can mark the skin of our soldiers. But it's been a long time since the last supply run. Too long.
If you think something happened to them, can't you send someone to go check?
Were it up to me. But Commander Draka is too busy securing his hold over the capital to spare any soldiers. My facepaint will strike fear in your enemies. Take a look.
You mentioned the village up north sends some supplies to the capital. Ash blood?
It's a crimson stone that we grind into powder for our ink. Bleeding Mark has the largest supply. Our soldiers there gather and deliver it to us, in exchange for their water rations.
Die for water?
Everyone in the clan depends on the wound in the sand for their water. Capital and outlying village alike. But the last delivery of ash blood was weeks ago. Our supply is running low. So must be their water.
If I'm out that way, I can look in on the village, find out what's the delay.
You have my thanks. Head north to a ruin where the desert meets the mountains. That's Bleeding Mark. Ask for Kentok or Natika there. They'll know what's going on.
I only stock the finest. Come back and see.
insights.
The wandering outlander.
Come, trade.
You might as well look the part.
Help it to mark.
Thank you.
Freezing frost won't help you. Here. The village Zoka was talking about. Looks like the whole place flooded. Maybe from a recent storm. I wonder if anyone made it out. Best check around the shore. There are a few survivors on that overlook. Let's see if they're okay. Is he all right?
He will be. There.
What about the others?
Let me worry about that. Rest now. I'm Natika. You're a long way from the east, Outlander.
You're Natika. So this must be Bleeding Mark.
What's left of it? How do you know this place?
The Inker's apprentice and Scalding Spear told me to find you. He was worried something happened to your supply caravan.
Well, as you can see, we have more important problems than delivering ash blood.
What happened here?
The last storm caused a deluge that brought down half of the mountain. The mudslide barreled right through the village. As you heard, we have many missing. But I need to keep watch on these two.
I can take a look around. If I find anyone, I'll send them your way.
Much appreciated. And if you see an older soldier, Grimfaced, goes by Kentok, Tell him I'm here.
Might be able to use my focus to find any survivors. That rubble's blocking the base of the crane. Maybe I can clear it if I pull that gimlet. Look, the water feels thick. Loaded. Guess this won't help the water shortage in Scalding Spear. Onto that.
Outlander! Up here! We've got wounded up here. We need an easy way down. Head back!
Hold on. I'll figure something out. I need to find a way for the Tenakth to get down from the cliff. That big crane could help. If I can get it, it must be stuck on something else. My focus can help me search. Thank you. Okay, crane's in place. Now, how to lower it to reach the cliff. I should take a look at the bottom of the crane's arm. See if there's a way to move it. I'm gonna try my best, see what it picks up. There we go! Oh, damn it. Arm's stuck on something. I better climb up and take a look. I think it'll connect. It's gonna take a shot at full draw to cut those cables. Focus might see something. If I detach those cables, the arm should drop the rest of the way.
The 10. How'd you manage to do that?
I don't know how you did it, but thanks for the rescue.
Is everyone okay?
His leg snapped against some debris as we were making a run for it, but he'll live.
How'd you get stuck up here?
A mudslide tore through the village in the last storm. This ledge was just above the flood when we got to it. But by the time everything calmed down, the water had receded, leaving us stranded. And we couldn't leave a fellow soldier behind.
Can you make it to the shore from here? Natika's there, tending to the wounded.
Natika. Thank the 10. We'll head for her location. She'll know what we should do next. When the mudslide hit, I saw some of the others running towards the metal towers. You might want to check there.
Thanks. I'll look into it. see anyone who looked. Machines. Must have moved in after the flood. Need to search more cauldrons to learn how to override that.
Outlander! These machines got us trapped up here. We lost our weapons in the mudslide.
Sit tight. I'll take care of them.
Looks like frost is no good here.
Crush him with the boulders! Shoot the support beam! Thank you.
machine can tough hold the cold. Frost won't help.
They're riled up now. Spot it. Gotta move.
Thank you.
Crush him with the boulders! Shoot the support beam!
Its net maws are as fast under the water as they are on land.
Can anyone hear us?
Where are you?
We're trapped in this tower. Flood blocked the way we came in. There's a ladder at the top, but we can't reach it.
Okay, I'll find a way to get to you.
I need to get to the ladder at the top of the building. Maybe there's a way to cross over from the broken one next to it. Crossing is not going to do much. You Frost won't help here. Machine was born for the cold. I don't have the overall data for that machine. We better look in the cauldrons. Shotgun will come in handy.
Ah!
Crush them with the boulders! Shoot the support beam!
If there's another cauldron with override data on that one.
Thank you.
better spot. Should be safe for the Tenakth now.
We're coming down!
Is everyone okay?
Better now, without Snapmaws prowling around. You sure know how to fight. During the storm, I think I saw some of our comrades running toward the metal towers on the west end. They might need a hand too, if you're willing.
Okay, I'll check it out. Have you seen Kentok? Natika asked me to keep an eye out for him.
Last I saw him was before the mudslide hit.
Okay. Head for the shore, on the other side of the village. Natika's there with the other survivors.
Will do. Thanks again.
Thank you. Could look around with my focus. Inside to get to the top. Should be able to cross over to the survivors from there. I can't shoot without ammo. There's the ladder on the other building. I can make that jump.
No! That was our only way out!
Everyone okay?
You're not one of us. Sorry. Yes. We took shelter in here when a mudslide swept through the village. But debris blocked the passage we came in through. That ladder was our only way out. But we couldn't reach it from here.
Don't worry. I'll find us another way out of here.
Do you know what happened to the others?
There are more who made it. They're safe now.
Thank the Ten.
As soon as you're out, head for the shore. Natika's waiting on an overlook there.
So she survived. Good. We'll join her as soon as we have a way out.
Okay. Sit tight, for now.
Okay, you should have a way out.
Thanks. We'll head to the shore in a moment.
Okay, I think that's it for survivors. I didn't see Ken talk among them. I should head back to Natika. Thank you.
Rest now. Aloy, thanks to you, these soldiers are safe. But where's Kentok?
I didn't see anyone who matched his description. Do you know where he was when the storm hit?
I was the last one to see him, just before. I told him I wanted to leave this place to pledge my blade to the Chief's guard, but he refused to discharge me from the squad. All Tenakth are stubborn fighters, but Kentok is more so than most. So I walked out. I was coming back from the opposite ridge when I saw the mudslide.
You were coming back to make amends.
I must find him. If anyone can survive such a storm, it's him.
You said Kentok is your squad leader?
I've trained under him ever since I was assigned to a squad. He's tough as a shell snapper. Unforgiving as the desert. But my blade is quicker, deadlier because of him. And he taught me to fight for duty, not just glory.
To serve something greater than yourself.
Yes. And yet he wants me to be tethered to this place, rather than fulfilling a greater purpose with the Chief's guard.
You said you wanted to pledge your blade to the Chief's Guard. Is that what the Marshals are?
No. The Marshals travel the breadth of the clan lands, enacting Chief Hekarro's will. The Guard remains at the Grove to defend it and the Chief.
What's the Grove?
It's an ancient ruin dedicated to the Ten, the bravest of soldiers from the Old World. Chief Hekarro rules from his throne there. Only a handful of soldiers are chosen for the honor of serving in the Chief's Guard.
So, why did Kentok not want you to go?
He claimed that the greater honor was to serve my squad and clan. But all we do here is gather supplies for ink. How can that compare to guarding the Grove? The Chief himself.
So a mudslide did all this? Must have been quite a storm.
We've had more and more of them over the last few years. Torrential rain, lightning strikes, winds that rattle the metal towers. But this last one was the worst yet. This area used to be as arid as the rest of the desert. The storms have changed all that.
There's a water shortage in the capital. Could this help?
The wound in the sand is low? Guess we're not the only ones dealing with problems. But unfortunately, no. This water's poisoned by ash blood, undrinkable as machine oil.
The Inker's apprentice in Scalding Spear mentioned you exchange ash blood for water.
It's the way of the desert, where other villages hunt for food or machine parts to trade with the capital. We collect rocks. Important rocks. The clan relies on ash blood to mark their skin. How can they record their glories without our supply?
I can take another look around the village. Where did you last see?
Natika.
I'm here.
Where's Kentok? Did he make it?
We're going to find him.
He saved me. Pushed me out of the way as everything collapsed. But then the flood took him. Towards the gouge.
The gouge?
It's an ancient passage that leads deep underground. Come, I'll show you.
Natika, we need orders. We're exposed out here. Only half of us can hold a blade if machines come.
What do you want us to do?
Go. The gouge is in the hillside, northwest of here. I'll catch up when I can.
What are we going to do now? Let's get a couple soldiers posted as lookouts to start.
through the gouge. Looks like an old mine. Not a lot of debris blocking the entrance. Maybe we can't get swept in there. I'm gonna have to clear some of it to get inside. Take it easy. You must be Kentok.
Oh. I was an outlander, not my name.
Natika sent me to find you. The soldier you saved told us you were swept away by the mudslide.
So, he made it. Good. And Natika, she came back?
Yeah. She was on her way back to talk to you when the mudslide happened. She's looking after the survivors now.
It was my mistake to deny her discharge. A soldier is supposed to sacrifice for the good of the tribe. Looking back now, she was right. I didn't want to let her go. The chief's guard will gain an invaluable soldier. At least after all this, I won't be in the way anymore. I can tell you know a fatal wound when you see one. My service to my clan is done. So, leave me.
No, you're not going to die down here. There has to be a way to get you out.
There isn't. I tried to climb out. It's no use. The walls are too slick.
Water's coming in. From the surface? But not from where I came in. There must be another source, and if I find it, and open it up... You might not be able to move, Kentok, but I think there might be a way to move you. Hey. Hey! I need you to stay awake. I'm gonna take a look around.
You're just like Natika. Relentless as a fireclaw.
And you should be used to it. Just sit tight. I'm going to get you out of here. That waterfall must be coming from somewhere. I need to get higher up to figure out where it's coming from. You should try getting one closer. Water's coming from that vent. There must be another source. That'll keep me awake. Okay. The waterfall I saw down below should be coming in from somewhere around here. Gotta find its source. Water's coming in from there. I can use the fire gleam to break open that wall. This should hold. Wrap can't up. The way out. Almost there.
Hey, stay with me.
Tell Natika.
You tell her yourself. She said you're a stubborn fighter, so keep fighting.
Answers only to the hand that commands it.
He would say that every time we sparred. Sometimes as an insult. Other times as a compliment. But I guess he was right. It was always my choice to stay or go.
I'm sorry you didn't get to make amends.
So am I.
What will you do now?
I'm not sure. Bleeding Marc has a chance to recover. And once that's done, I could join the Chief's Guard. But I have to lay him to rest first. With full soldier's honors. Aloy, wait. You saved my comrades, somehow drained the entire village. I want you to have this.
Thanks. And good luck. Whatever you decide. I'll have to explore more to find the parts I need. Ways with this machine for now.
Yeah. location in your focus.
Thanks, GAIA.
A rush of air.
Thank you.
Gate of the Vanquished. Fitting place for Yara and Draka's challenge, I guess. At least it didn't become a bloodbath. Getting close to Aether's location. I said it would be in some kind of physical processor. Tenakth warriors everywhere.
Many more soldiers killed since. And Regalla's arm.
Regalla's forces may seem strong now, but.
Her machines took out my entire squad.
Remember the visions. The old ones didn't choose their fight, but still, they stood firm. They didn't falter. Neither will we. Blood of the Ten. You've come to us.
You know who I am?
Oh, the warrior with hair like wildfire who defeated Regalla's champion at Baron Lai. Yes, you are known to us. I am Dekka, chaplain of the Lolan clan. You've come to speak with Chief Hekarro.
Not quite. There's something I need here.
Anything you need, the Chief will provide. Come.
Is that one of the visions you were talking about?
Yes. The records of the Ten. I can show you them, if you like. On the way to the Chief.
These visions, you said they're the records of the Ten. Who are they?
Old ones, who fought a heroic battle against machines on this very soil long ago. Their deeds are honored in the visions. At least what remains of them. To be remembered and exalted.
There used to be more of these visions?
Many more. Once this place was filled with light and sound. But over the years, they've fallen into darkness, one by one. That is why chaplains are so important to the tribe. We remember all we can of the visions, etched in our flesh, passed down by word of mouth from generation to generation. One day the whole grove may go dark. But chaplains who come after me, will keep the memories alive.
Why does Hekarro want to see me?
We're at war with Regalla. And you've already shown that you can stand against her.
I'm not here to fight a war for you.
Not for us. With us. But I won't try to persuade you. That is for the Chief. He can be very convincing.
What does it mean to be a chaplain here?
We who outlast our youth study the visions and share their wisdom with our young.
What kind of wisdom?
How to be a true warrior. To fight with bravery and unflinching honor. And to know when to call for peace. You can see for yourself when we go inside.
All right, let's go see Chief Hekarro.
He's in his throne room. At the far end of the grove. Come. Be welcome among the records of the Ten.
Come, soldier of the Ten.
It's glitched. Incomplete.
Joint Force 10 active. Led by Gerard. These weapons were
the Ten were dedicated soldiers, working together as a squad and sharing in their duty. When the time came for battle, they took to the skies and leaped to glory. All Tenakth seek to follow their example.
Since Bleeding Mark.
For the Chief, it was one of the few things the clans had in common.
Well met, Aloy.
During their war, the Ten climbed sheer rock, braving blinding snow and wind. They stopped at nothing to protect their own.
You make them sound invincible.
They weren't. But the visions tell us of their courage and strength. Something our soldiers aspire to. The Sky Clan admires this one above all the rest. They make their home in the mountains northwest of here.
What's this one about?
The Ten waged war against their enemy in the desert heat. A land too harsh for any to survive. But against all odds, they prevailed. So the Desert Clan does the same. You must have passed through their territory on the way here.
I did. They seem a little extreme.
They take that as a compliment.
Aloy, it's been a while since Bleeding Mark.
Join us, Deep War Rainforest. jungle, sealed by darkness. To trap their enemies.
Soldiers in a jungle. Those were the ten?
Yes. They knew how to use the jungle's depths to distract the enemy until the perfect moment to strike. Generations ago, my clan, the Lowland, looked to this one for inspiration as they claimed the jungle to the southwest.
You have an old world recording?
This box was speaking with voices of the old ones, but now there's noise over them.
Let me take a look. Where did you find this?
We took it from an Asaram Delver. She was trying to steal it, and other artifacts from Tenakth territory. The others were going to bury it in the sand with her. But then I heard the voices.
Well, the data here is badly corrupted, but...
Delta Juliet 9, you are weapons-free and clear to engage the swarm. Good hunting.
Copy that. We'll buy Zero Dawn the time you need. Delta Juliet 9, out.
The voices of warriors from the past. And that Asaram wanted to sell them for shards. The bravery of the Ten should be remembered.
I'm not sure what you mean by the Ten. These voices came from the final battle of the Old Ones.
Another battle? I could learn more about it if I could find the other boxes. That Delver did say there might be more recordings to be found in the wreckage of ancient flying machines. She claimed she had a way to locate them.
Yeah. The box with the voice data on it is emitting a locator signal. I could use it to find the others.
If you do, then, bring them back here. I will see to it that they're treated with proper respect. Whatever sacrifices were made by these ancient soldiers, we will honor them.
I've already found a recording.
I'll take any you find. Let me give you something for it. These voices will be kept here. They will be remembered.
Do you get many Asaram Delvers in Tenakth territory?
Fewer every time we catch them, but those thieving rats would do anything for the shards. There'll always be some who'll risk coming here.
And what do you do with the ones you catch?
Delvers spend their lives in the dust. So we bury them in it. Alive.
Why do you want these recordings?
Every battle teaches its soldiers. We should learn those lessons, and honor those who fell. That is our way.
If I find more of those recordings, I'll bring them back to you. My focus can detect beacons from those recording devices. Should help me to find any others that are still out there. Find this in my stash later.
The chief is inside. Are you ready to see him?
I'm ready.
Good. Come.
Underneath the throne.
I will see you soon, Outlander.
The Savior of Meridian. I am told you held back Regalla's forces outside Baron Light. And defeated her champion, Grutta, in single combat. Impressive.
I met Fashav there, too. He said you were a great warrior. And a man of honor.
His death is a painful loss among many. We will not soon recover from the massacre of our marshals. But if you are here to pledge your service, that could help considerably.
I am not here to fight for you. I need something in that basement. Something that will save many lives, yours included. It's not something you can see, but it is there.
I have seen it. You have named your price. Now I name mine. With my marshals dead, I need your spear. Help me defeat my enemies. And I will grant you access to the chamber below.
I don't have a price. I am not a hired killer. I'm here to save lives, more than you can count.
I count the corpses of marshals slain. I count hundreds more Tenakth, whose lives hang in the balance. I will fight for them. I will kill anyone who threatens the peace, and you will too. If you want me to open the door to the chamber below.
Okay. So by that logic, what's stopping me from killing you right now? And taking what I need to save everyone?
You could try. You might even succeed. Either way, you must fight. My way might hold off Regalla and the slaughter she craves.
Fine. What do you need?
I need more marshals to keep the tribe together. Such warriors can only be promoted at a trial by combat called the Kulrut. I've sent out a call for the competition. But since Regalla seeks to undermine me, she is certain to attack it. She'll want to kill me in front of the assembled clans.
So what, you want me to be your bodyguard?
No. To defend the Kulrut. But there is more. Knowing Regalla will attack, one of the clans have balked at sending their contestants. You must go north and force Tikote, the commander of the Sky Clan, to submit and send his best.
Force him to submit?
Do whatever is necessary. I can't hold a Kulrut with two of the three clans in attendance. Marshal Katala will assist you. He was maimed at Baron Light, but he can still be of use. I sent him ahead to the northern village of Stonecrest. Meet him there, and he will guide you to the Sky Clan stronghold. If you have any questions about your mission, now is the time.
I'm sorry about Fashav. You seem like a good man.
More than a man. A bridge between Tenakth and Karja. No outlander ever earned our respect as he did. I had hoped he would be my voice in Meridian. That peace with the Karja might become something more.
An alliance?
An exchange. The Karja have much we lack. Our deeds are written in ink upon our bodies. Our memories die with our flesh. But the Karja never forget. Their deeds are written in book and scroll.
You wanted to learn from them?
As I learned from Fashav. He will be missed.
Fashav called Regalla your greatest mistake. Why?
That is not your concern.
Really? I fought against her forces at Baron Light, and I don't even know what her problem is.
She was the deadliest of my marshals, the point of my spear.
So what happened?
Above all, Regalla despises the Karja who burned her younger brothers alive. After we turned back the Red Raids and tore down the battlements of Baron Light, she hoped to chase them all the way to Meridian. She could not see the cost of such a war, nor the benefits of peace after the Mad Sun King fell. When I accepted Avad's entreaties, she went mad, called me traitor, challenged me before the marshals.
What did you do when Regalla challenged you?
If you were Tenakth, you would know that such a challenge cannot be refused. It was not easy to subdue her. I bear 7 scars from that fight. The other marshals wanted me to execute her on the spot, but I found I could not sever the bond between us. Her loyalty had been as boundless as her rage, so I spared her. Rather than mercy, she took it as a humiliation. One she will never be free from.
So Regalla wants you dead.
She does. But that will not be enough. She won't rest until all 3 clans fall in behind her as she marches on Meridian. Who knows? With machines under her control, perhaps she can raise it to the ground.
It's been tried before.
So I hear.
What exactly is the Cool Root?
Where once the clans fought each other, now we fight as one. Against the machines. That is my law made manifest in the Cool Root. Each clan must send contestants whenever I call for the ritual. These contestants face trial by combat against machines in an arena just beyond these walls. Those who distinguish themselves become marshals who bind the tribe together as peacekeepers.
You called them peacekeepers, but the marshals I met at the embassy were warriors.
Warriors, yes, but more. They renounce the clan that birthed them and pledge themselves to order and peace. They enforce my law. They settle disputes and stand for Tenakth in parley with other tribes. Without them, I cannot rule. Which is why you must ensure the next cool route takes place.
Why won't the Sky Clan send contestants to the cool route?
Of the three clans, they have the most defensible base, protected by a mighty wall called the Bulwark. Their commander believes he can wait out the war between Regalla's forces and my own, safe behind his barrier.
Staying strong, while you and Regalla weaken each other.
You think like a seasoned marshal. Good.
Why send me to deal with the Sky Clan?
All Tenakth respect strength, and you drove Regalla back at Baron Light.
That and most of your marshals are dead?
Correct.
What about Katalo? Can't he do it by himself?
He is maimed. They will no longer respect him.
That hardly seems fair.
What is fair about losing an arm? Whether they respect him or not, Katalo still has worth. He knows the Sky Clan. He was raised in their base. He will guide you well.
You said you saw what's in the basement?
I did. On the day of my greatest victory.
What do you mean?
For a dozen generations, the three clans battled for control of this hallowed ground. Only I achieved it. I fought for years, killed whoever stood in my way. When I had finally slain all rivals, I stood alone in the grove. Victory was mine to savor, or so I thought. Thunder roared from the east, and a bolt of blue struck this place. That chamber.
GAIA dies, and Aether arrives.
All around me, the visions of the grove grew louder and brighter, and suddenly a new one appeared before me. The old one spoke, and what they said changed everything.
What did the old one say to you in this new vision?
The one called Faraday foretold the growing danger of the machines and said we must unify to stop them. She called for marshals to enforce the peace. Then the vision faded, never to be seen again. I marked the spot where it shone with my spear, and I took Faraday's words to heart. Renounced war between the clans. Trained warriors to fight machines, ordained marshals through the cool route. Since then, the tribe has been at peace, until Regalla attacked at Baron Light.
And the chamber beneath the throne. You went in after the vision?
I did. Inside is an ancient device. It hums with power. You will see it for yourself after the cool route. This I swear.
I'll do what you want, and go north to deal with Dakota. But you'd better not forget about our deal.
You will have what was promised, if you succeed. Speak to Dekka on your way out. She will arm you for the road ahead.
Come, let us speak.
Hekarro said you have something for me?
A weapon to aid your mission. You'll need it for the long road to Stonecrest. Many machines prowl along the way, and our scouts have sighted Regalla's rebels in the area.
Machines and rebels. Nothing I haven't faced before.
Indeed. Head north towards the foothills. Ascend its slopes until your legs burn and the chill air catches in your chest. Then you'll know you're in the Sky Clan's domain. Strike true as the Ten, Aloy.
If I'm gonna get Aether, guess I'll have to play along with Hekarro. I better meet up with Marshal Catallo at Stonecrest. I'll be faster if I ride a machine. What's this place?
I've heard of you, Outlander. Your exploits must require supplies. We'll be back soon. I'm sure of it. How can I help you today?
Hot as an Osirom forge, as Erend would say.